Have you ever had an image hardcover that just simply won't spread no matter what you seem to do? If so, this video might be just the one for you. Grab a drink, get comfy, let's do this. I found personally that with most image hardcovers, the volume one is either a much tighter bind, a glued straight in bind, or just slightly overglued in general, and that makes for a much poorer experience on the first volume of the book. For Revival, I actually found that it was that way for books 1 and 2, so I've already actually stretched out book 1. So this is the book lifting up totally fine. As I say, you can see how the book lies out totally kind of level, and we get a nice eye in the book itself. What it was doing originally is exactly what this book does. You'll find that you get this big kind of arcs happening in the pages. You get absolutely no lift from the actual kind of binding away from the outer spine of the book itself. And you're kind of just fighting it the whole time. I know some people are going to have various kind of reservations about essentially attacking your books, and I'm going to put that warning out there now. Please don't do any of this on my kind of say. I'm not telling you to do any damage to your books. I take no responsibility for what you do to your books. This is just because, say, I've had a few people asking off the back of some of my closer looks as to how I've got my books to spread, and I thought, as I said, I would show you guys how I've managed to kind of do that. You really want to make sure that it is a sewn bind. So you want to look for these signature loops in the end of the book, and obviously check that the rest of your books are spreading okay and that look the same, because that then indicates that this should spread. Whereas if this was just straight glued in end, I probably wouldn't bother with this, because I might end up damaging the book or kind of just stripping away those pages where they were not supposed to lift up in the first place. So you want to make sure that you do have a proper sewn bind before you even start on this. So I need to get this sort of ribbon part and all of the binding to actually lift away from the hardcover. Now, when I was originally doing this, I was actually using a sort of letter opener which had a sharp kind of end, and the problem I found with that was when I was sticking it in here, it actually somewhat dug into the end kind of spine, and a couple of my books actually got ruffled up in the spine area. So this is again why I'm giving disclaimer: anything you do here, it's going to be a learning curve, and I want the book to naturally kind of lift. I don't want to kind of force it too heavily. The main thing that I find that helps if you have too much glue or things in there is any of your tools that you're using to clean things or to kind of separate it. Coat the tool originally in sort of sticky stuff remover. That will mean that when it's going in there, it's not getting stuck to any of the glue. And it'll also help if there's a little bit of this left in there to just kind of loosen up any left over glue if you close your book up again kind of afterwards. You don't want it re-sticking in place again. I usually apply this to just a kind of microfiber cloth and then actually rub my tool on that rather than soaking the tool again, because I don't want to go too heavy on any kind of glue or anything. The two things that I'm actually going to use to hopefully lift this up, provided it all kind of works out, is from my Ag Fix-It kit. So the reason this is quite useful is because it's not too long, so it's not likely to kind of flex and dig into the hardcover, and it's also completely flat, so again, it kind of stops with any of those kind of issues. The curve means that I can put it into smaller books without kind of pushing it in too far and causing any kind of damage, but as I said, it's a work in progress, so something like a flat butter knife or something might work just as well as this. And then the other thing I use is this kind of silicone black stick. And again, just because it's kind of anti-static, all those kind of things that come with normal kind of toolkits, and is quite thin and not going to cause me any issues damaging the book. There's nothing sharp as such to dig into anything. So as I say, it's just a quite useful tool for, again, helping that separate and lift a little bit. I'm going to put a little bit of the sticky stuff remover on here first. So as I say, just a little bit there on the cloth, and then I'm going to just rub my tool on that to get a little bit of a coating on the tool itself. And then what I want to do is basically have the book in its natural position, which is, as I say, slightly open. And then I want to basically put this in between the main kind of binding part here and the hardcover. This is going to be quite hard to show on camera, so forgive me if this isn't the best angle or I cause some small damage while doing this. This is just the best way that I can kind of show it to you guys. So this goes, as I said, in between this kind of gap here, and it's just to cause an ever so slight kind of separation. So I'm just going to put it in a tiny bit to begin with. As I say, I'm only rocking it kind of side to side. I'm not lifting it up and down. I'm not trying to pull anything away right now. I'm just trying to see how hard fixed the glue is. So I'm just going to give that, as I say, just a little bit on that one side. And then slide that back out again. And then I'm going to just wipe this down and do the opposite side. And you can see already there's a bit of glue on the end of there. So then we want to go into the opposite side as well and do the same thing a little bit, just a tiny bit on the edge of the book itself. Now you are going to hear slight tearing while you're doing this because you are separating glue. Again, it's to what you prefer to do. I'm not telling you to do anything, but there is going to be a bit of a tearing sound that you do get sometimes when you're separating your books. As I say, I'm only really going in that sort of maybe about 1 centimeter into the book. I don't want to push it to the point I'm digging into the hardcover, and obviously my tool is slightly wider than the book, so I don't want to go any further than that. So that's the top. Done pretty well. I'm going to go back and do the bottom a little bit more again now. And I'm cleaning my tool between each time to make sure that I'm taking any excess glue off the tool itself. And obviously making sure I've got a nice coat of sticky stuff remover on there. So now that we've got to that point where we've separated up the edge just a little bit, I want to give the book a little bit more of a stretch because the whole idea, from my perspective, is to get the book to lift naturally. I don't want to force it too much and cause any damage to the binding. So I'm going to give this a further stretch through the book itself. And when I'm doing it a little bit heavier, what I do is I actually place my hand down on the kind of pages and angle it back each time when I'm kind of going through each angle. So rather than just kind of placing the sides down, I'm actually now trying to get the book to kind of naturally lift just that little bit more. And this is when I then take the slightly longer tool. And again, we want to make sure that we're coating the tool in the sticky stuff remover because we don't want it to get stuck in there and start tearing at anything that we don't want it tearing into. So we're taking the flat edge, and again, we just want to slide it in a little bit to cause it to rise up a little bit. And because this is a little bit of a wedge, it is going to cause that slight separation. But just so you guys are aware, when I'm typically doing this myself, I've got the book up like this, and I'll actually kind of change through different parts of the pages to make sure that each part is kind of spreading as I kind of want it to. You can see here. So again, I'm going to give it a little bit of a clean and we'll do the bottom again. I can go maybe 2, maybe 3 centimeters kind of down and just kind of in there. And I say all I'm trying to do is cause the initial kind of separation. I'm not really trying to dive into the further kind of spine parts of the book. And then again, as we go through each stage, we're just again doing a further stretch of the book to make sure, you know, that we've got that separation kind of happening where we want. So again, after the black stick section, what we're going to do now is a further kind of stretch point. And you might find by this point that you are getting a little bit of a rise out of it, but you might not. Start in the center and then work towards either side, but going smaller bunches each time, because I find that you want more stretches towards the edge where this kind of bump is to get that initial kind of rise up to happen. So again, center of the book, just pulling it back just a little bit, and then we'll go to the right first, and then to the left of it, And then I typically actually go the opposite way around, because I find that when you're holding a book to one side, you're only really stretching that one side. So if I do the back of the book, it'll stretch it at the back as well. And you might find that different ends of the book stretch a little bit quicker than the others. And then this time what I'm going to do is actually try and lift it slightly with the black sticks. So when I place this in here, I'm going to actually consciously kind of just lift up ever so slightly and almost kind of just turn it a little bit so that we get that little bit more of a kind of separation, and then sliding it a little bit more up to the sides, just again to cause that initial kind of separation to lift a bit. And you can see this is properly separating a little bit more now. I like to change the pages that are open each time, again just to make sure the spread's happening evenly. And how far you have to go with this is really going to depend on the individual book. So it's a bit of kind of trial and error. Okay, and this is probably going to be the, I guess, the cringiest part for most people, because you are going to have to somewhat force the book to lift up. So again, with what we were doing last time, you want very central first. If you start with the pages are kind of up against the edge almost straight, you want to hold them against the hardcovers. You're not pulling them up or pushing them down. You're just holding them in place. And then when you're pulling open the book, you should find that the eye now starts to open up a little bit in the end. And what we want to do is, again, work our way from one side to the other. These books can take quite a bit, but it's your own risk to kind of do this. I'm not saying that you should do this to your books, but this is how I get mine to lie out a little bit nicer. And so this is just the initial kind of lift up. And then, so you go back to the centre, and then off to the other side. And then I usually flip the book around, as I said previously, and do the opposite side to make sure that we're evenly kind of spreading both sides of the book. And you'll see the eye is really opening up now. At this point, what I would do is go to the back of the book and basically just go through sort of a couple of pages at a time and try and kind of flatten out the overall kind of spread as much as I can. Again, causing the book to hopefully lift up a little bit. So again, I'm not pulling anything apart. I'm just pushing the actual binding here to cause things to flatten out a little bit. And again, you're going to hear paper creasing and things like that as that kind of goes. And you'll see now that the book is spreading out a lot better than it was previously. I'm going to do it once this way, and then I'll flip the book around and I'll do it the opposite way. So now what you'll see is when we open the book up itself, the eye actually lifts up quite nice, and we've got that start of it kind of rising up. At this point, I would do a further kind of one of the earlier stretches that I was doing with the kind of bending back, but not go quite so heavy, and just generally stretch the book across the board. So again, just lightly this time, we're not looking to go anything beyond kind of flat. And we're just trying to get the book itself to kind of sit at that flat point naturally. I tend to focus on the tail end of the book because, again, it has to get past this little bump. So once I've done a couple of stretches in the middle, I'm spending a lot more time stretching the edges of the book than I am in the middle. Now, I would want to note at this point, when it does separate, if they have overly glued, sometimes you do get these little glue spots that kind of come through where the stitching is. If that's going to bother you, again, that might be another reason not to do this. but it doesn't bother me. I'd rather get the rest of my gutter back and have a couple of white marks than not have my kind of book rising where I want it to. I find that when I'm reading the book for the first time after doing this stretch, I might have to, every maybe chapter or so, just do a lighter kind of stretch like this just to get the book to lay out flat on the first kind of read through. But then once I've read through it once, I'm pretty much all good from there. So as I say, the book just lies out really well now. And once you get to the centre, there's absolutely no issues. It lifts up totally fine. As I say, we've basically got no guard at that point. It's lifted up at this side, and it's also lifted up at the top. If you've watched it this far, thanks for kind of sticking through the whole thing. Hopefully this has been helpful to you guys to, you know, how to stretch out, as I said, those kind of first volumes of Image hardcovers. Thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next one.